But you have got strong views about interviews. Because when I met you...
Strong ones.
You were very strong with me about interviews.
Oh, yes.
You said, for instance, you thought that interviewers shouldn't ask certain questions.
It's true. I don't think people... If you go to somebody's house and you're having a dinner with them or a lunch with them, and they ask you about certain questions, I think there are certain things that you're, say, personal things, which you are considered to be rude. For instance, if you go to somebody's house as a guest, there are certain things that probably you wouldn't want to be asked in normal conversation, you know, which you'd consider slightly impertinent.
But
if I go to see a girl, the first thing I don't ask is, how old are you? You know what I mean? People are touchy about certain things, you know?
But you had more positive views than that. You said to me...
What we were arguing about, I was saying about public entertainers, particularly comedians, what I was saying was that when I'd been interviewed in the past, I didn't like to discuss political matters, religious matters, and money. Mm. Now, money, because I don't think it's very tasteful to talk about money. Secondly...
Politics,
I'm quite strong about, because I think that if you talk about politics and come down on for a political party, some people can do it, some people want to do it, and they're entitled to. I personally don't. I've never talked about politics because I think that if you don't get involved in politics or don't hammer and thud about it, you can then are free to take the mickey out of them all. You see, you have to have, in my opinion, players, and you have to have audiences, you know, people watching the players. Mm. But you also need a few umpires. You need a few referees who aren't involved, but can look at it and be objective. Now, I think for comedians, certain comedians, it is far better for me to be in a position to take the mickey out of all of them. And it's very difficult to do if you very strongly come down for one party. Do you understand?
I agree. So that you mean the comedian is your umpire, you're saying?
But I can be. It depends what the sort of comedy you do. But if I was doing a satirical programme, and I enjoy doing that, and I think most comedians sometimes bring politicians into their jokes, it's much easier if you aren't, for a comedian, not to be a fervent supporter of any one particular group, and then he can take the mickey out of everybody with an unbiased attitude. Now, some people would disagree with that. They'd say, no, you've got to, but I believe in that, you must put your views forward. They do this in America strongly. Artists strongly support political parties. I have never felt this particularly, you see, that I've my own opinion is, if I may say so, that comedians are best being funny. You see, that's their job. Mm. Now, I'm not a politician and I'm not a priest, and therefore I've tried to make a few corny jokes over the years and to amuse people, and that I see as a function, not to do anything else. And after all, if I may say, my political views are of no more importance than anybody else in this studio. In fact, probably less, because I'm a bit of a dimwit. I'm not an intellectual. And therefore, why should, just because I happen to be a well-known comedian, why should I have to thrust my views on other people?
But are you frightened?
Yes, go on. Point to you, if I may. Suppose, for instance, you have a very strong group of popular singers, and they say to somebody, vote something. Who are the people voting for? The singers? Or the political party because they happen to believe in it. So I think that people who are in entertainment business, unless they want to show political views, and they're quite entitled to show them. I'm not all for it if they wish to. All I'm saying is I don't personally wish to.
But it must leave you freer, mustn't it? Because if you're satirical, you can be satirical about whoever is around. Right.
Yes.
Now then, coming on to religion then, what's your objection?
May I say, before we get off that one, all I was going to say is this, that if you I can see good in most things, in a way. If people produce an argument, I can see their side of it. Other people produce other arguments, and I can see their side of it. And often one has got to see, you know, it isn't easy unless you're a very decisive nature to pick out I can see good and bad, you see. And I can be sometimes swayed from one to the other. So I'm not easily come down on a side. I don't easily do it. I'm inclined to be a little wonder and remote from things, in that kind of things. But this is a different thing from following causes, from doing what you can to help people, to help causes, to help things that you believe in. That's a different thing altogether. I mean, if somebody comes out with an idea to help somebody, there's no reason at all, and I've done a lot of it, supporting causes.
Yes,
that's a vastly different thing from coming
down. Yeah, but you told me about that particular thing about charity, where you said that, you know, because you were famous, you were worried that people would think that you were doing something good in order to get publicity for yourself.
Yes, I used to think that a great deal. It sounds, please sound pompous, but over the years, I got quite very well known in the country over the years, and I was asked to do a lot of charity things and help people, which I was very pleased to do. And I thought to myself, well, now, I don't want people to think that I'm using people who are suffering to get to capitalize, to get publicity for. So I used to think, whatever happens, I must not do this, not get too much publicity. So I used to go out of my way to avoid it. I used to say to people, yes, I'll do it, but please don't tell everybody. I don't want everybody to know. Because I think, and in any case, life had been very lucky to me in many ways, and I thought it's up to me to repay it, to do what I can to help other people. Yeah. A lot of people have been kind to me. A lot of people have helped me. People have stood by me in troubles. And I thought, it's up to me to help, to give something back. That was what I thought. I was repaying a debt. And so I didn't want publicity. But one day somebody said to me, do you realise that by being all this over-modest stuff, you're being stupid? Because people like to be photographed with you. It gives them a thrill. Also, you help the charity. You give it some publicity which it needs. And all this stepping backwards doesn't necessarily help the charity because they want publicity. And I suddenly thought, being rather slow and the penny it takes 20 years to drop, I suddenly thought I've been rather silly about all this, and so now I don't take the same attitude.
Right, but you don't want to talk about religion either, you told me.
Well, I think the religion's a very touchy subject with most people. It's a very private subject, and I think that if people have strong political views, I'm not a priest, I'm not anti-religion, I'm not religious at all, but don't suppose that. I was used to be a Sunday school teacher, but I don't want to get into great philosophical talk about religion and I think there again, I think if people want to do this, they're entitled to do this. But I think comedians are best being funny. That's what they're best employed doing, just to amuse people, help them a bit, just to have a laugh. Now, I enjoy laughing at comedians. I need to laugh at comedians because I often get fed up like everybody else does. And I find watching television, listening to music, watching plays and theatre, it helps me. I get therapy from it, you see. So I'm all for that. But I think that when the comedians possibly start airing their religious views, I don't think it's important to me necessarily what they feel. I must work it out for myself. And I can be helped by people, but not necessarily by any particular comedian or interviewer.